Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa barik wa sallim. Surah Yasin, lesson 45, verse 33 continued. Wa ayatun lahumul ardul maytatu ahyaynaha. And a sign, a symbol for them is the dead earth which we revive. Wa akhrajna minha, and we extract from it habba, a seed. Faminhu ya'kulun. And that seed is what you eat. The fruits of that seed, in other words, is what you eat. So there are many aspects of this verse, and we've touched on death. And just to conclude with the idea of death, in that death is, it's not nothingness. It's not a complete morbid state where everything ends. But rather, death is a transition from one state of being to another state of being, and a severance or a separation of body, jasad, and soul, ruh, or spirit. This separation is what we understand as Muslims as death. In Arabic, we say maut. Okay, the actual extraction from the body, that ruh from the body, is done by a malak, an angel, by the name of Azrael. And Azrael is not an Arabic word, but in Arabic, most of the scholars of theology of Tawheed, they say that Azrael bima'na Abdul Jabbar. It is the servant and slave of the compeller and the conqueror, Abdul Jabbar. And just to give you a picture of what the old books of Tawheed have inside them describing this malak, this angel, is that his head is in the highest heaven and his feet is firmly pitched into the lowest of the seven earths, the lowest, in other words, recesses of the earth, of creation. And his face is directed toward the Lawhil Mahfuz, that preserved tablet, while creation is before his eyes, like insects walking around. And his helpers amount to the number, exact number of people who die. He has a helper to assist him with every single person. And toward the believer, when a believer dies, he appears bi suratin hasana, with the most beautiful features and appearance, and pools their souls with gentleness, complete gentleness. This is part of our theology and our beliefs. We can quickly become accustomed to a depressing state and have some hate toward death. It's difficult. It's something we must experience. But there's some twist that happens here, which I've experienced without having done these classical texts, is that you focus more on Allah's wrath, His anger, confusion occurs, which opinions to take. And literally all it takes is sitting before someone teaching you the Kutub al-Mu'tamad, the texts that have gone tested and tried over the centuries. And one of the challenges we face is that all those books are in Arabic. And the way to open it is you need to find somebody who can read those texts and has read those texts with somebody who is qualified, and things just become clearer. And one of the pitfalls that we find ourselves in is that there's almost none of these texts are taught anymore at places of knowledge. It's more modern texts that are taught, which is fine, but we need to connect to our rich legacy. I mean, if I ask you, who is Imam Suyuti, who is Imam Nawawi, who is Izzuddin Abdus Salam? If you go into Medina today, just ask a taxi driver, where is Imam Malik buried? And I can almost guarantee you, they'll ask you, who is Imam Malik? They don't know. Such a legacy, it's a separation, almost like the soul separated from the body, is that we find such a disconnect with our legacy. Just another point on death is that regardless of how the person died, it was the appointed time. It can never be delayed, not by a second or a split second. And your references for that is the Quran, Surah 7, verse 32, Surah 16, verse 62. Allah Ta'ala mentions over and over that the appointed time is the appointed time and it can never be delayed. Imam Ghazali, rahimahullah ta'ala, in his Ihya Ulumuddin, in the Kitab of Death, Dhikrul Maut, the Remembrance of Death, has a rather fascinating narration by Al-A'mash, who narrates on the authority of Khaythuma, that the angel of death, Malak al-Maut, once approached Sulaiman alayhi salam, Sulaiman bin Dawood, the son of Dawood, and was staring at one of Nabi Sulaiman's companions for a long time, like a stare of death. And when the angel of death left, the man asked Nabi Sulaiman, "Oh Sulaiman, who was that?" And Nabi Sulaiman told him, "That was the angel of death." And he said, "I saw him looking at me with such a stare, almost as he looked through me and wanted me." So Nabi Sulaiman asked him, "What do you want me to do?" And this man said, "I would like you, O Sulaiman, O Prophet of God, to deliver me and send me through the wind, or order the wind to carry me to the furthest part of Hind of India." And he ordered the wind, and the wind blew him to the furthest part of India. And when the angel of death returned, Malak al-Maut returned again to this gathering of Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salam, he said to the angel of death, "I saw you looking closely at one of my companions. You stared at my companions." And Malak al-Maut said, "Yes, indeed I did." And Malak al-Maut told him, "What astonishes me is that I was instructed by my creator, by Allah Ta'ala, to pull the soul of your companion in the furthest part of India. But I just came here to check why is he here, when in a few moments time I must pull his soul in India. And I was shocked to see him here. But the destiny of God is that he has been blown to India by the wind through your mu'jiza, your miraculous nature." So the gist of the story is that Malak al-Maut was shocked to see this man in a gathering of Sayyidina Sulaiman when he was ordered to pull the man's soul in a few moments time in India. But the qada and qadr is just that. It is how it is. There is no way of changing or delaying our death. When we find a hadith to say that good manners and charity and righteousness increases lifespan, it means it makes life more full, more fruitful, more blessed, with more barakah. It's just like your rizq, your money. I'm sure you've heard that there's more barakah in my wealth. It means that with a little, you can do a lot with it. It reaches further. So our aqidah is such that death could never have changed, not a moment longer or shorter, that we should find some ridwa, contentment with Allah's qada, with His decree, and that we do experience that sadness when someone is taken away from us, as did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when his son Ibrahim passed away. That shows compassion, but deep down we need to find contentment with Allah's qada and His qadr. Next, we will start with verse 34 and go into verse 35. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.